Anderson and Greg Anthony. And with us on the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Hey there, Kevin. Jrue Holiday has taken the Bucks to another level. He says HUD, Giannis, Chris, they love guys that go downhill and get to the basket. That works out with my abilities. So it's a great fit. He just being aggressive helps out the team. Kevin, they love the ball in his hands.
He makes good things happen. Always has. He's been a terrific fit. David, thank you. Here are the starters for Milwaukee. Giannis and Lopez hold down the post for him. Holiday and Allen have guard duties. And it's Middleton at the three, the small forward. And for Chicago, the wing set for him, Levine and DeRozan. Williams and Vucevic hold down the post for him. And it's Caruso in at the point. You know, the first thing you think of with both these teams, Greg, their athleticism. Some high flyers on the court tonight.
And, Kev, it's not just about the aerial skills, though. There are some guys who flat out wear you down with their ability to run the floor.
So here we go. The Bucks win the tip. Here's Allen. And the basket is good. He's got a chance here for one more in the line.
Yeah, going hard into the rack, making a statement here early on.
Yeah, it's nice to see him be assertive instead of settling for a jump shot, especially in the first quarter.
Here's Caruso.
Last time with their defensive pressure and the ability to force turnovers.
this defensive game plan is a thing to see, making them change things.
And here on the first approaching 3 minutes play, here's DeRozan. Williams trying to break free.
DeRozan is the presence felt at the rim.
Looking at the last game for Milwaukee, it was a loss to the Boston Celtics. Outside Holiday. Here's Young. And there's the bucket stand with the offensive pulse getting it done.
And they're offense already in a flow. 2 minutes stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
And it's sent back by the Bucks. 1:49 left to play in the first quarter. And it's Antetokounmpo penetrating.
Long strides of Antetokounmpo. Once he gets downhill, there's almost no stopping him.
Caruso, the pass to DeRozan. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. Antetokounmpo's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
The defense is kind of shaking aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
Yeah, it's going to take better rim protection than that if they're going to climb out of this hole.
Levine for three. Hands it from downtown. Dosunmu in for Alex Caruso. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Connaughton's check in. And the call will go against Grayson Allen.
Grayson Allen
is his first foul of the game. Personal foul. Goran Dragic is checked in for the Bulls.
Checking into the game for your Bulls.
Here's Dosunmu. Now the pass to Vucevic. It is good. And it's in for Vucevic.
Great start for him.
I know Dosunmu
could be in for the game.
Holiday, the pass to Allen. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time.
Three.
Allen's got a couple of threes now in the first for Milwaukee. Pass to Dosunmu. Inside. Vucevic with the bucket. Vucevic has got 10 points.
He's doing everything he can. If they want to win, others have to step up and provide some scoring.
Goes to
Bulls trail by six. Floats one up. And the rejection. My gosh!
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender. Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Holiday with the three. Here's Antetokounmpo. And he battles for the ball. Gets the second chance ball. He's got eight.
He's got a knack for those putbacks. So you have to be aware of that defenseman. Get a body on him.
And DeRozan gives to Vucevic. Off target at the rim. Offense, the order of the day is in this quarter. Bucks for close. Bucks lead by six. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. Dragic with the ball for the Bulls. 6-point game. And at home for the next game, it'll be Detroit pulling into town. And that'll be the third or fourth straight at home. They've got Vucevic. Dragic is out there with Dosunmu. And it's DeRozan. And it's Bradley in at the four. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Richard, safe to say you were a pretty good defender in your day. So tell me, who was the most difficult player you had to defend?
I've had to guard some of the best scorers in NBA history. Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, LeBron James. But there is nobody like Kevin Durant. His height, his skill set. KD is probably the
Lopez. Lopez with the steal. That one is good. He's only missed one shot. He's six taken on the floor.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes it back.
Yeah, they got to do a much better job of putting a little bit of pressure on him on his way to the hoop.
Here's Dragic following the basket by Brook Lopez. Here's Vucevic. That's it, coming off an assist from Dragic. Vucevic has got 14 points for the game.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
Here's Connaughton. Trains it from beyond the arc. Connaughton's got the lead of 12 now for the Bucks.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct. Just fanning the flame. Always plays hard until the final whistle, no matter what the situation is.
Offensive rebound. Out to DeRozan. Here's Bradley. Good D by Lopez.
Fantastic defense, giving full effort.
And so the ball goes on the block. Chicago making a switch here. Drummond's checked in. Chris Middleton's checked in for Milwaukee. Now here's Dosunmu. Lopez with the block.
And we have seen Lopez really improve his shot blocking. Adept at using that length to alter shots. Yeah, great outside shooting. Really fueling this run.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Chris Middleton. Foul of the game.
Second, that's a second, and I think they'll keep him in. He's got to be careful. A third, and he'll sit for the rest of the half.
Here's what Chicago's going on right now. Green comes in for Vucevic, and Zach LaVine sub in for Goran Dragic. And then for Milwaukee, Portis, he's checked in for Lopez. Matthews comes in for Grayson Allen. And it's harder in for Chicago. And with an update from the sidelines, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Not that long ago, of course, the analytical team shot way more three-pointers, and they found a temporary edge. But now every team shoots a lot of threes, and it's more about personnel. And if you shoot the star shooting the ball, that mid-range jumper can be very efficient.
With the assist. And D.A., we see it all the time. Brandon Ingram with the New Orleans Pelicans. KD, the two players in Phoenix. With Chris Paul and Devin Booker, DeRozan in Chicago. Hit those all day long. Hit a thank you. And they're bringing you up close and personal on the AT&T 5G Slam Team.
Middleton, their third three-pointer in a row.
Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Outside, LaVine. Popped up there for trouble. And it's trouble with the jam.
LaVine demonstrating just how unselfish he is with that great pass.
Kevin, what's so impressive to me about LaVine? It's the all-around play. He affects the game across the board.
Bulls trailed by 14. Outside DeRozan. The 17-footer. They get it back. The second effort. And Drummond kicks to DeRozan. Drummond trying to get himself free. Goes up again. And finally they hit one. Drummond's got his second bucket tonight.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And LaVine's efficient as well.
And good shooting numbers, no doubt. Last year he cut back on the turnovers.
Middleton.
Boy, he's still young. There's still tons of upside to be had.
High post try. DeRozan can't get that one to fall.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down. And he is that open.
Cruising from outside.
Three. He's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
And of course, it helps space the floor, which gives this offense more room to operate.
It's Antetokounmpo on the wing, guarded by LaVine. Matthews dishes to Middleton. And another three for Milwaukee.
12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks shell-shocked.
And so LaVine will bring it up now for the Bulls. DeRozan passes to Green. Cut that one. Green's got his first basket of the night.
It's almost like he's got a full-time view of the court. DeRozan always knows where his teammates are.
Traps in the tray.
3 points. This is that modern big man play. Tall guys who are comfortable draining shots from deep.
And here's DeRozan after the three-pointer from Bobby Portis. Shots good by Green.
Green has been an all-star. Zach can be the playmaker or the scorer.
Giannis, that's a two-pointer. That's in there. Giannis Carter with the assist. Giannis has got 10 points in the game.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball move.
And it's good for two.
Okay, I see you, DeMar, putting defenders on skates. A little whippity up.
Hey, yo, right here.
Carter kicks to Portis. Beyond the arc. The shot will not fall. Here's DeRozan. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. He's got it.
That possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Shots good by Middleton.
And if you're trying to get the most out of Middleton offensively, they're in a catch and shoot situation.
And through one half, it hasn't even been close. The Bucks on top, opening up a huge gap. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Booch. They had it going the first two quarters. How do you turn that around defensively?
Just gotta get one-on-one stops. Do a better job helping each other. Just getting whatever they want on that end. And we have to do a better job. And it's just simple. You know, one-on-one stops. When we help, make sure the guy that helps, he gets help, and just keep rotating. We haven't done a good job with that. We're usually very good with that. So just gotta focus. And come back and take it half ready. And we can make it a game if we play better defensively.
Thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it. Back to you guys.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime. And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
After one half of play, it's been a one-sided affair. Hey, everybody, welcome back. This is Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. A nice show being put on tonight by Chris Middleton. He ended up with 19 points and one rebound. He's been a different player than he was in their last outing when he was off his game. He's rounded back into form tonight. And Kenny, what did you think about what we saw from Milwaukee?
Well, when you pass the ball the way they have, Ernie, I mean, this is the kind of scoring line you expect. The guys are totally different. It's a ball mover. I mean, they're moving the ball around and it's striking.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
The shooting percentage they allow was through the roof. The coach is absolutely terrific.
Lock it in.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter. After a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got, sharing the wing spots, it's Allen and Middleton. Giannis and Lopez hold down the post for him. And it's Holiday in at the point guard. And that replay showed just how forceful that block was.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
Outside, Levine unloads from 13. Here's Williams. Makes it off the glass. Williams has got the first points in the second half here for the Bulls.
And despite the size disadvantage, attacking the heart of that defense. Really unfazed. Throw his height right out the window there.
And one more look at that fantastic Mobile One drop.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself. And even though he didn't see a ton of time on the floor in his 1 year in college, nobody doubted Patrick Williams. Finding lanes to the lane now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Allen, the bounce pass. Outside out.
team, and it didn't take long for Williams to live up to his potential.
Now, that's where basketball can be so funny sometimes. He started every game his rookie season after not starting at all at Florida State. Let's just say he's might be more
capable than this, and I've been impressed with the unselfishness, but also getting guys the ball where they can do something with it.
His court vision has been on display in this one. He's doing a tremendous job just orchestrating the offense beautifully.
DeRozan's shot is off. Bucks leading by 20. Lopez kicks to Middleton. Hits the three-point bomb. Middleton's got 22.
A nice start to the second half. They've made three out of their first four shots coming out of the break.
DeRozan for three. Rebound, Milwaukee. Middleton right side. It's good. The assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got six assists here tonight.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Yeah, not just an impressive showing on offense, but on defense as well, executing their game plan perfectly.
Now here's Allen, following the miss by DeRozan. Takes the three, and another three for Milwaukee.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. Without question, Chris Middleton displaying his skills today.
They have to come up with a new wrinkle defensively because he is the one and only Chicago
Bulls. The Bucks are making a change here. Donovan's checked in. So far,
it's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
In the modern NBA, you have to hit threes to win games, and they've made that adjustment since the break.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Off target with this three.
And even though he hasn't hit himself, it hasn't affected his team.
2 minutes remaining in the lead. Williams gets the bucket.
Settling for an outside shot, they went right to the hoop.
Milwaukee's gone 3-5 with the long ball since entering the second half. Back to Holiday, lets it go with a three. The Bucks keep it going. A new 14-second clock. And Lopez gets it to go.
Can't let Lopez get comfortable down low. The second he does, there's no stopping.
Here's Levine. A rebound by the Bucks. Giannis has got 13 rebounds in the game. Class eating. Passes to Connaughton. Now Holiday lets it go from deep. Holiday with another miss.
His consistency just hasn't been there this quarter in terms of his shooting.
Williams can't get it to go. Here's Milwaukee now. They're on a 17-6 run. 2 points, that one goes. Connaughton's got his second basket of the night.
And the passing skills of Giannis continue to improve. His floor awareness has grown through the years.
Count that bucket.
Allen, it's a great piece of work to get to the hoop there. Just tore the knee to shreds.
Antetokounmpo with the ball. Now guarded by DeRozan. And Antetokounmpo gets it to go.
How about the effort? You did make a little contact with prevent Giannis from scoring, did you?
Here's Williams. Lopez with the block. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Changes for Chicago. Tony Bradley's checked in for Williams. Kobe White comes in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Dragic in for Alex Caruso. And then for Milwaukee, Joe Ingles comes in for Chris Middleton. And George Hill's subbed in for Jrue Holiday. Now, here's Bradley, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring in from him.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And the basket by Ingles.
Joe Ingles. A knee with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
Now now the feed to Vucevic. And that comes off the assist by Levine. Levine's got his fourth assist in this one. Here's Antetokounmpo. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
And I can't think of a higher percentage look than that. Giannis, one of the best ever.
And so it's the Milwaukee Bucks with a 34-point advantage heading into the break. A three-point shooting has come fast and furious to the tune of what has become a big-time blowout in progress. We'll return shortly. Let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And how about the big fella here showing us he's got some point guard skill here with the tremendous setup.
And for the defense, it's so tough to guard a big man with that kind of court vision and dime dropping ability.
The fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. And so he'll bring it up for Milwaukee. And after this one, they're home against Minnesota. They start a three-game homestand with that game. So with Vucevic on the bench, here's the group. Billy Donovan is on the floor. Bradley is out there with Andre Drummond. Then there's Dragic. Then it's White. And it's Green in at the small forward. Out pass from Hill. Matthews. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line. Guys, let's get your typical hustle stats for the Bucks. We know Grant the league trending towards small ball, but some teams are having success playing two bigs up front.
And I think the key is having versatile big men. If they can space the floor and play in space, also be able to cover smaller players, why not get the added rebound? And guys, he's not an easy man to stop. He's got the whim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. Now, here is Hill. Oh, good on the three. Green up on top. He's covered by Matthews. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Matthews. First personal foul.
Free throw drops for Green.
Team foul.
At the line for the Bulls.
And both free throws good for Green. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. And here's Hill for three. Buries it from three-point range. Hill's got himself on the board with three there.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
And the ball will be against George Hill.
George Hill.
That's his first foul.
First personal foul. Second team foul.
So it's Chicago now. White finds Bradley. Takes a three, and again, Chicago, no good. Bucks have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. And here's Matthews from the arc, and it's Bradley with the rebound.
That's a look you cannot pass up. It's also one you shouldn't miss.
Here's Dragic, and the rejection by Ibaka.
And, well, he's been the NBA's leader in blocks multiple times. Ibaka just has that instinct for it. You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
And all of a sudden, that man was just on the other end. Wow.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
Still going hard, and that kind of energy and effort is how they built this league. They're clearly struggling here with the foul. Still early. And just one more. Carter put him over the limit.
And the Bucks making a change here. Carter's checked in. Game moves along. 2 minutes gone here in the fourth. White, good.
Oh, yeah. Attacking the interior is something White does well. He's crafty, and he makes good adjustments against the defense.
Now, here's Ingles. No good on the triple. Now here's Dragic, the best break opportunity. And it's set back by Hill. And it's on the bounds. They say it was last touch by Hill. Chicago making a switch here.
Derrick Jones Jr. Terry.
Terry outside. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Yes, that goes in. Jones has got his first bucket of the night.
Well, White has quickly developed great floor vision. Doesn't miss the wide open man.
And here's Hill for three. Good on the triple.
Jordan, and no matter who it is, three. That kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Here's Terry. We've seen some kids go directly from high school, RJ, to the G. Terry, how do you think that's working out so far?
Green and Kaminga sure look good. And look, I think for a small smack, they should go and start working on their profession. No different than a musician, a tennis player. You should go and start focusing on your profession. But for other players, they need college development. I needed college for 3 years, and then that is what helped me become a better pro.
Wasted no time on that one.
Three. So many of the plays they're running designed to create opportunities from deep.
With the way they're shooting, there's no need to look for any other shot. Just keep running away.
First opportunity for Chicago. Alex Caruso comes in for Javonte Green.
Substitution on
and Milwaukee with a change here, too. Wara checked in. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. On offense, here are the Bucks. They're on a 14-6 run. Carter on the wing, launches a three, gets the three-pointer to fall. Carter's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. The Bulls have got just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth, 4 of 9.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Bucks.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. On the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And you can mark this one down for the W count. Of the season.
And with this win now, we're all square, 1-1. Two more games yet to come in what's proving to be a very competitive season.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Giannis.
And what effort he had on the boards, displaying some great fight, willing to battle down low.
Now, here is Ibaka. Shoots over Caruso, and there are the Bucks with another bucket.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
And it felt like they just hit the switch to go on that one and see saving their best basketball career. He may not have that traditional power forward build, but his balance, well, that kind of levels the playing field.
3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Ibaka finds Hill. And Jones pulls it down. And so it's Terry bringing it up for the Chicago Bulls. White, wide open, he fires. Can't nail the jumper.
And if you ask me what percentage of the time he's making that shot, my answer would be in the single digits.
And those are the type of shots that just drive coaches crazy. Look, I would be shocked to see him sitting on the bench if he tries that bad boy again.
End of the so game. No problem for Milwaukee as they hit the win. A resounding victory for them. And break in enemy territory, no one.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Giannis, you have said in the past you have even more untapped potential. So how did you put your fingerprints on this game?
I'm just here to do whatever it takes to help my team win. Did a great job executing, move the ball. And this is what we do. This is what we do. We play together, and whatever we do, hopefully we can get a win at the end of the day.
Well, it certainly turned into a win tonight, man. Thanks. Back to you guys.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. This is Kevin Holland thanking you for watching. We'll see you later.